Today we will start Adobe Photoshop CC. So first, in Adobe Photoshop CC, CC stands for Creative Cloud. Adobe Photoshop is basically a graphics editing program developed by Adobe System. Here, graphic editing program means it mainly deals with the creation of images, audios and videos. So Adobe Photoshop is a software that is used to alter an image to make it more attractive and brighter. This software is mainly used by the graphic artists, web developers to make the website more attractive, photographers to alter the photo to make it, to enhance it and to make it more attractive, as well as people, they opt it as a hobby. These days most of the posters, magazine covers, book covers and brochures, etc. are created with the help of this software. And because of its popularity, this software has proved its usefulness and it sets an industry standard for graphics professionals. That is, these days almost all professionals who are involved in this industry prefer to use this software. The next is features of Photoshop CC. It has a revised user-friendly interface. Here, user-friendly means we can interact with this software very easily, that is, in user-friendly manner. Using this software, photo editing became more efficiently with very little efforts. It has redesigned powerful tools to enhance or change the color of an image by adjusting the brightness and contrast, color balance, saturation levels, curves, etc. That is, we can change color of image by adjusting brightness, that is, we can provide the photo lower or more brightness. Crop or resize pictures without losing the quality of an image. That is, we can make an image smaller or larger without losing its quality. Photoshop CC provides various options along with the crop tool to make it work even better. Using this software, the unwanted object from the picture, for example, a pimples on a face or any unwanted spot can be removed using vanishing point tool. So this is one of the most important feature of Photoshop CC. Click and drag across an image to make fast selections with the new quick selection tool. That is, this tool is used to select the image very fastly. We can create graphics for web applications with reduced file size. So it helps in faster loading of the website. That is, using this we can store a file that occupy minimum space, or create a file that occupy minimum space or lesser space. Files can be compressed by 10 to 50% of its original size. That is, it can be reduced to half or tenth of its original size. So it saves our storage space. We can also make animated graphics विच इज़ ऑल्सो नोन एज ग्राफिक्स इंटरचेंज फॉर्मेट GIF. We all are familiar with GIF, that is graphics interchange format. Layer effects preserve the original state of an image while manipulating another version of it through another layer. That is, when we edit a photo, its original image is preserved using layer effects, while we can edit in it in some other layer. And one of its most important feature is its 3D effects. 3D effects incorporate, that is helps completely new and improved extents to an object by introducing new 3D reflections, icons and draggable shadows. An improved print window simplifies printing options and it eliminates the need for separate print and print with preview commands that we usually use in the application like MS Word, Excel and PowerPoint. That is, it replaced print and print with preview command by print window. That is, we can perform the function alone only in print window that we usually use in the print and print with preview in Word or Excel or PowerPoint. And the new auto align and blend features save our time, and the tool recording using actions in Photoshop CC enables us to add brush strokes and different helpful tools. And the new addition of the video timeline panel enable us to add effects to the video clips in the Photoshop. And blur gallery allows us to apply and combine three different kinds of blur and create effects. Content aware patch allows us to heal undesirable portions of an image, that is, it allows us to remove any spot, unwanted spot, that is dark, on the images, or any undesirable part can be eliminated. Content aware move enables us to select pixels and drag it to some other part of an image without using layers or masks. The magical part is that it fills the hole with matching elements from the existing background and shifts the pixels to a new location. And a new adaptive wide angle filter enables us to straighten the curves and lines in photographs and quickly achieve effects on the images where there is a less space. So these are the important features of Adobe Photoshop CC. Starting Adobe Photoshop CC, it's very simple. To start Photoshop, just follow the sequence of steps given below. If it is installed in your computer, go to the Start menu and click on the Adobe Photoshop CC. In the components of Photoshop CC, there are various components like menu bar, title bar, option bar, panels, workspace, and tools panel. It will be explained one by one. The first is menu bar. As likely MS Word, Excel and PowerPoint also having menu bar. So this term, with this term we all are familiar. It is the topmost horizontal bar in Photoshop window that contains all the main menus of Photoshop like file, edit, image, layer, type, select, filter, 3D view, window and help. Among which file and edit, we all have been using this in the Word application, Excel or PowerPoint. And window and help, these two menus also we have used in other applications. So with the four of these we are familiar. And options bar, control panel. Option bars options bar control panel lies just below the menu bar. It displays the options related to the currently selected tool in the tools panel. That is, whenever we select any tool in the tools panel, the various options related to the selected tool are displayed. The next is document window. It is the workspace, that is, it is the area that displays the image file that we want to edit. And the name of the image appears, image file appears as a tab at the top of the document window. Panels. Panels literally means a group, that is collection. On the right side of the Photoshop window, there is a separate area for panels. Photoshop offers various panels that can either be grouped, stacked, or docked by using various options from these panels. We can monitor and modify the properties of an image. That is, after modifying, we can watch the modification of an image, and panels can be placed anywhere on the screen. To do so, just click on the top of the panel and drag the panel by pressing the left mouse button and release the button whenever we want it to place. Color panel. The color panel displays the color values for the current foreground and background colors. As its name suggests, it is a collection of various colors. We can also use the sliders in the color panel to change the foreground and background colors using different color modes. Here, foreground color means the color of image, and background color, as it literally means the area that we see behind a photo or an image. We can also select a foreground or background color from the spectrum of colors displayed at the bottom of the panel. These all we will do during the lab. And the next is swatches panel. The swatches panel stores the most frequently used colors that we have been used recently. Adjustment panel. As the name suggests, this panel helps us to apply an effect to a group of layers in a much easier way. We can edit that effect while preserving the original layers. Original layer means the layer that consists the original image. And the adjustment panels has a styles tab to its right. A styles panel. It consists the various styles, like this panel allows us to view, select, and apply preset layer styles. Here, preset means presets are basically settings that are applied to a photo, enhancing the image with just a click of a button. And the history panel. We can access our documents history in the history panel and undo the changes easily. Layers panel. As the name suggests, it consists various layers. It displays all the layers in an image. It also shows the various effects applied to the layers. Tools panel. It consists various tools. Basically, the tools panel works like an artist paint box. That is, it consists almost all the tools that are required to create a painting, like brush tools, paint, etc. These tools help us to draw, paint, and manipulate the images. That is, we can modify the images according to the need. Now, creating a new file. To create a new file, we just open the Photoshop. However, this is lab oriented, 100% lab oriented. But this time we just look at a glance. To create a new file, we just open the Photoshop and create a new image file by selecting the File New option. This process is much similar to create a document in Word. And this will open the new document dialog box. And this dialog box allows us to create document using the selected templates from Adobe Stock across several categories that include photo, print, art and illustration, mobile, film and video within the dialog box. Here, template means a template is a pre-created document that already has some formatting according to its name. Like photo template has been formatted already as per its need. And also, we can also find more templates by using the search for more templates on Adobe Stock search box. And quickly access files, templates and items that we have recently accessed from the recent tab. That is, the items that we have recently accessed, we can access those files with the help of by using recent tab. And we can save our own custom presets for use in the save tab. Create a blank document using the blank document presets. Then we click on the photo category and select any preset. Here again, presets are basically settings that are applied to a photo, enhancing the image with just a click of a button. That is, preset or settings. We can set up the size of an image file in different units of measurement, such as pixels, inches, centimeters, or points. Here, pixels, we all are familiar with this term, but I would like to explore this term. Pixels, it is the number of dots per square inch. A high pixels image have a good quality. And specify the value for resolution to determine the sharpness and clarity of an image in the resolution text box. Resolution, we generally use high resolution camera or high resolution camera. So what did it mean? What does it mean? A high resolution camera having high pixels. If you take a photo using high resolution camera, it has having high resolution, that is number of dots per square inch is more. That makes the photo more clear. And mention the color mode such as RGB, CMYK or gray style in the color mode text box, and provide the background color of an image by defining either of the three options. And click on the create button. A new blank Photoshop canvas will be created with a locked background layer in the layers panel. And the next is inserting images. We need to insert image to edit it. That is, if you want to edit an image, then we must insert it. To do so, you can do so by the following steps. Open a new file in Photoshop CC, and then we click on the file menu and choose either the place embedded or place linked option. And in the opened place embedded window, browse and select image file that we want to insert and click on the place button. However, this topic is also lab oriented. We will do it more during the lab. Then we click on the image and drag it to the point where we want to place it within the canvas. We can also resize the image by dragging one of its corner nodes. When we are satisfied with the placement, size and rotation of the image, we just double click on the image and it is placed. Saving a file in Photoshop, Adobe Photoshop CC, is much similar to save a file in Word or Excel. To do so, we just choose save option from file menu. Then save as dialog box appears. Here choose the location as that is where we want to save the image, and provide specify a name in the file name text box and click on the save button. The file is saved. And closing a file. To close a file in Adobe Photoshop CC, we click on the close option from file menu, the file will be closed. And opening a file, this is also much similar as we open a file in Word or Excel. To do so, we just click on the file menu and select the open option. The open dialog box appears. Now we browse and select the desired file, that is file that we want to open, and click on the open button. The selected file will be opened. We will do the above said topics during the lab. So first, you all are requested to install Adobe Photoshop CC in your PC or laptop. The rest of the topics of this chapter will be discussed during the next video.